Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I'm available for code reviews and on-site training. Now, in this episode, I'm going to cover C++ 20's explicit bool specifier. We're going to see why you might want such a thing and see if it might be applicable to your code. Okay, so you may or may not be aware that you can mark you can mark constructors with any number of parameters, actually, as explicit or not. So let's go ahead and look at what this means. Now, I'm on GCC trunk here with C++ 20 enabled and all kinds of warnings and errors and everything. I'm going to create a new type. I'm going to call it S because that's a handy name for a struct. I'm going to make this a templated type. And it's going to contain some sort of thing. Now, you might think of this like, say, a strongly typed wrapper or some sort of a standard optional, maybe something like that. And you've got some desire to be able to convert this thing S to and from a contained. And I've made a constructor that takes an R value reference to the contained thing and a constructor that takes a const L value reference to the contained thing. And I've got some sort of get member, shall we? Something like this. And now for convenience, sometimes you want to actually be able to have the compiler implicitly convert this thing for you. So a conversion operator might not be uncalled for here. Now, this might look kind of weird to you if you aren't familiar with the syntax, but it says, if an object of type contained is required, then I'm going to return a copy of my contained thing. And now we could do R value or L value reference qualified member functions for our operator contained or something like that. Let's stick with the version that we have right now for simplicity. Now let's just pretend like we have a function here that wants an object of type S that contains an int. Because we have marked this function not explicit, then it is an implicit converting constructor for us. So I can call a function that expects an object of type S of int and pass it an int, and it is going to automatically call this constructor for us. And we can in fact actually see that it's automatically calling this constructor for us because it's the only line highlighted up here in Compiler Explorer. And we do have our optimizations enabled at the moment. If I have another function that expects an object of type int, and I pass into other func an object of type s of int, I need to give this a default constructor. Then I'm passing in an object of type s of int to a function expecting an int, and it's actually calling this conversion operator here for me. Now, these conversions, implicit conversions, can actually be very expensive. And I personally think that standard string never should have had an implicit conversion from a const character literal because it gets us in trouble all over the place with a bunch of expensive copies. So pretty much everyone agrees that these functions should be marked explicit so that it avoids this potential problem of having expensive conversions and copies happen all over the place. Now, I want to do a quick aside and note here that if I have the move constructor marked explicit, it knows that it can't call that one. Well, sorry, move constructor is a bad word, but the constructor by R value reference. And so it calls the constructor by L value reference implicitly. So we actually get a different constructor called because I added explicit here. So let that one just kind of maybe mess with your head a little bit. But let's go ahead and make these explicit again. And now we get a compile time error. The compiler is saying, hey, you can't do this implicit conversion because this is potentially expensive and it reduces type safety and has all other potential problems. Now, as of C++ 11, we can also mark our converting constructors explicit. So now we get compile time errors on both sides. And I would have to explicitly call .get right here, and I would have to explicitly create an object here. Now, I don't honestly know what the original motivating intention is for conditionally explicit constructors. But I will say, and conversion operators, I will say that I can see a case where you can make these things conditionally explicit, where if the contained type, the conversion is cheap. If the conversion is cheap or free and does not cause a code bug, then in C++ 20, you could do something like this. Using a type def here or something like that would probably be smarter than what I'm doing right now. But if I have an int that I want to pass in, or if I have this thing, then I can say this thing is explicit only in the case where it is containing something that is not trivial. So now it will work. Now I have implicit conversions to and from a trivially contained type. But if I were to go back and have something that is not trivial in here, such as a string, now I'm going to get this compile time error because invalid initialization of reference of type const string from expression of type string, note passing argument one here. Because I have made this conditionally explicit on whether or not it is a trivial type, then I cannot call it here. Now, the error that I'm actually getting from the compiler is kind of terrible because it's not telling me that it was because the constructor that it could find or the converting operator that it could find was conditionally explicit here. So let's just, for the fun of it, also try clang trunk. Here we go. Candidate not viable, no matching function, candidate not viable, no known conversion. Okay. It still isn't giving us a great error, but that is a use case for conditionally explicit constructors and conversion operators. And C++ 20 makes this very easy to actually use by using our explicit that takes a constexpr bool parameter to determine whether or not these things should be explicit or implicit. I feel like this is a tool that is probably going to be used very little in average code, but might find some use cases like my example here in the case where something's trivial, and it probably has a lot of use in various standard library kinds of applications. So thanks for checking out this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope you enjoyed it, and be sure to subscribe, leave a comment.